is like creating a scrapbook. Memory undergoes several phases. The first phase is encoding, which is the scrapbooker's insight and inspiration into their creativity. Another phase processes into consolidation, where consciousness can be used to the set of representation that composes the mental state of a person at the time. The embedded representation of the past with other embellishments, whether it is a photo or arts and craft experience, incorporates them into the representation of the present moment. After that, then, it needs to be retrieved, which is the interpretation of templates, elements, and illustration, which each person looks at the plain photo. It can be one thing, but the plain photo and arts and crafts showcasing stories and meanings. Scrapbooking can be done with photos or without. Every picture tells a story, and that memory can change through experiences as they happen. While most of us are stuck in our homes and are in quarantine due to the pandemic of coronavirus happening, most of us are having a sudden urge to go outside, social, and travel the world during this quarantine. However, you may come across recent photos or old photos that you have posted on social media or on your smartphone that you may have not thought about it much. But looking back and reminiscing at those memories was meaningful experiences to you. For example, these photos at the snow, especially the one that I was in the process of making a snow angel. Ever since the injury that I have sustained from a multi-collision accident, I do not think I will be able to make a snow angel again until I fully recover. If you have never made a snow angel, it probably didn't mean anything to you, because if you see the photo, you will be saying, "What are you doing?" Nevertheless, you were on the snow making snow angels, and it would be fun and cold. If you have never made a snow angel and your sister never woke you up and asked if you wanted to make a snowman, this could be a negative memory. In my metaphor, the negative memory would be the nuts and bolts task part of scrapbooking by assembling a scrapbook page. The positive memory would be the creative way to find emotional healing and provide a time of great reflection of our life. It serves as a way to capture and cherish each moment that is priceless memory. Both aspects are like the enhance of amygdala schemes. I would say that the amygdala relates to the scrapbooker's creator. They are likely to create arts and crafts with a photo that is meaningful to them or someone else if they are making a scrapbook as a gift. I think that in my metaphor, representation can relate to the receiver as well. We all have a unique and creative styles in arts and crafts, that unique trait, which is like how we recollect things differently. We all remember in various ways and are unique individuals. Every person is unique in their creative ways, creative styles of the art and craft with a photo transmission. It may mean that each individual can disagree with the intention of the original plain photo of how it is viewed without any explanation. However, the background of the photo and the arts and craft can paint a more explicit memory and tell a story. Thus, in the process of being encoded, consolidation and retrieval each time, proteins are forming memories. The molecular components are forms that a scrapbook page is assembled with everyday photos when you start creating layouts, journaling process, and adding embellishment that it will tell more of the story than just looking at a plain photo.